Hello guys, welcome to Wailing Heights. This is supposedly a musical adventure game with 2D comic book artwork. How that works out, I'm not sure, but we shall find out shortly. Let's start a new game.
After the tragic news of today's events, and the loss of the last surviving member of one of Britain's greatest ever rock and roll bands, the next 24 hours, GBB1 will be paying tribute to the Deadbeats, to Fangs, Shaggy, Spectra, and Zed. May you forever be at peace. The fearsome foursome is reunited once more.
We are the Deadbeats. The real is coming in the dark of night. If you catch the sight of us, you may die right. We are the Deadbeats. We should be resting 6 feet on the ground, but we're here to play our music. We can't stop.
Frances! Oi, Frances! How are you, mate? Aye, aye. Bite me, Finklestein, eh? Eh? Listen, Finklestein, got you a gig. Yeah, seems now all four Deadbeats are pushing up daisies. Almost immediately everybody wants to get their hands on good old Bite Me Finklestein. Right, mate, mustache, lucky day, eh? Well, I mean, not the death bit, but still. Looks like your life's about to turn around. Ta-ra!
You ready for adventure? We love the scene for you.
Act 1, anybody will do.
Mr. Finklestein, Frances Finklestein.
So let's click to choose dialogue and hold CTRL to select. So we can switch here between what we want to say in the speech bubble. So being a comic and all, we'll just say gasp.
Ah, good, you're awake.
Well then, seems you've gotten yourself into a bit of a muddle, Mr.
So, yeah, we can't actually see, but Frances? I don't know. Let's just say Mr.
Mr.
Well, that clears up the first question. Due to your, condition, I'm afraid your case file is a little bit on the light side.
Condition? What am I? Am I dead?
No, actually. That's the problem. Personality aside, you're quite alive, and I'm afraid there are laws against that sort of nonsense in Wailing Heights. Technically, the charge is illegal thresholding, and with your current biological status, we're in a spot of legal bother. You see, we can't allow you to stay in Wailing Heights. But at the same time, we can't let you leave. Here, why don't you have a biscuit while we sort this all out, eh?
Let's say biscuit.
Biscuit?
Finklestein. Where have I heard that name before? Ah, of course! Bite me, Finklestein! Now I recognize you! Your old born loser Finklestein from Here Come the Deadbeats! How could I not have picked you outright? Bite me, Finklestein. Classic. Anyway, yes, well, that fills in your history a bit. Didn't think I'd be representing a celebrity today. Well, not really celebrity, but you know what I mean. Right. Occupation, plucky comic relief, peripherally attached to the Deadbeats.
But I wrote all of the songs.
Peripherally? But I wrote all the songs.
Yes, quite. Hey, do you want to hear something funny? I'm a bit of a musical maestro myself. You'll probably recognize the voice.
So go man, so go man, SoulGaming.
No matter the crime, there's a legal loophole. So if you're feeling guilty, better call Soul.
What just happened?
Soul Gulman, public defender for the deceased.
I've never heard lawyer rap before.
Good, isn't it? Here, let me get you some tea. I'll be right back. Help yourself to a biscuit, they're lovely.
I think my lawyer should rap more when I call him.
Holy smokes. Either Manchester Monster Menagerie has an elaborate prank budget this year or I have a ghoulish jail to escape.
WASD to move? All right. She's a little bit stiff in the walking department. Let's head out the door here.
This door is locked.
So now we are playing as a normal adventure game now. I guess we have to click on stuff and find the... and find some items, maybe?
They look pretty horrible.
What, the chains?
Still, I am kind of peckish.
I see, having a little bite there.
Ugh! Oh, disgusting. I think I just swallowed a cookie's corpse. Still, Mam always said never pass up a free meal. Oh, was that Elvis who said that? I always get the two confused.
Hey. Hey, buddy. You look like you're in a pickle. If you can pass me up a bit of grub for my escape out of here, I'll make it worth your while.
By grub, do you mean food or actual grubs? Or by worth my while, do you mean actually I don't want to know? Or let me check my pockets. We did put a cookie in the pocket, so let's just do that.
Let me check my pockets.
Oatmeal raisin. Well, beggars can't be choosers, I guess. In exchange for your awesomeness, and seeing as I won't need it anymore, I want to give you something.
A possession wheel?
What is this thing?
Haven't you seen a musical possession wheel before? Add the right ingredients, find the right words, and you can sing your soul into another body. Oops. Your boy Gulman's coming back. Adios. Just remember the musical formula. Find a real name, something they love, an item they hate, and you can possess anyone's undead body.
It's an interesting mechanic. The possession wheel. With this wheel, music holds the power to possess the dead, collect personal ingredients, write them into a song, and sing your soul right into the subject's cold, lifeless body. Add a character's name to see possession lyrics, then find a love and a hate to possess. To find the perfect lyrics, talk to the locals, explore the town, and of course steal things from other songs.
Right then, tea and biscuit, civilized. Ah, I see you started without me. What do you think of the biscuit, eh?
Yummers.
Ah. There's nothing I love more than a biscuit, yes, sirree? Love, love, love these cookies. Ah, so, back to our little conundrum.
Lucky for you, I know exactly how to sort this out. I'll just glide over to Town Hall, look up the Human Rights Act, we'll have you out of here in a jiffy.
Just a few cases ahead of you. And in order to access the law library, I'm going to need to earn myself a promotion, which will require me going back to law school for a bit longer. A trifling matter, really. All told, I should be back with an update in about...
80 years.
80 years? But I'll be dead in 10!
Haha, well, that certainly works out in both our favour, doesn't it? Anyway, I need you to sign here, here, and here. You can use my...
As a man who enjoys his paperwork, I hate, hate, hate pens that don't work.
I wonder why he's not colored. Maybe he's a ghost. And that's a bullet hole right there.
Oh, I'd love to add that to my broken pen collection.
Don't see why not. Weirdo. Before we finalise all this, I'm going to go over the fine print, just to make sure you understand everything. Are you sitting comfortably?
I haven't been comfortable with any of this.
Excellent. Let's begin. Clause 1.1.0a. Insofar as, forthwith, aforementioned, whereas, notwithstanding in perpetuitous habeas defense duration of exceptio probat de regulorum deberis non exceptus, blah blah blah, blah 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 blah, blah 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 blah, non, blah 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 blah, nonsense, etc., etc.
I have the three items needed to possess soul. Press Y. So what do you press when you're playing on the keyboard? I guess I'll just grab my controller and press Y. There we go. So now we can put... place a character's name. I guess this is the name. Oh. His name is Sol Gulman. Likes the chocolatey chip baked inside of the dough. He likes this something crisp but messy writing. He can't handle that, and that's what makes him crack. Chocolate chip, something like that. And we, I guess we need the. Let's just remove these.
Soul Goldman, Soul Goldman, Soul Goldman.
His name's Soul Goodman, likes his chocolate chip baked inside of the dough. He likes his cookie crisp, but messy writing, he can't handle that. And broken pens, that's what makes him snap.
Well, that was weird. Ah! I'm scaring myself.
Your possessed soul, press Y, or the space bar to read comic origin. Ah, so here we get his backstory as a comic. It's always the same when you are a ghost looking back on whatever time you called a life. Your freshest memories are the last moments, and everything works backwards. Backwards from the end came to an earlier time when it was all in front of you. I'm afraid things are as bad as you have heard. We have only gone and hit a bloody iceberg. To the boats, as quickly as you can. To the boats, unless you are a man. So I guess that's a musical in the theater. I discovered at an early age I was a prodigious talent with a fine singing voice and a gift for rhyme. Oh, headmaster. Young soul has a prodigious talent with a fine singing voice and a gift for rhyme. So that's how he discovered it, because he told him. Unfortunately, he has a face for radio. All my life, I have been a retro musical revisionist, a human sampler in it. My journey through the life was a musical journey through the history of the age I lived through. I saw more chances than David Bowie. So here we have, was it the Rolling Stones that had a similar picture? I think so. Where they crossed, I think they were naked, maybe. Actually, I don't remember. My genius face was, of course, my hybrid barber, shop quartet, and urban rapper face, barber rapette. My album shot back and size went platinum in every country that could afford it. Haters gotta hate, losers gotta lose, tattoos and beards are yesterday's news, little rhyme. So it's going well. Dern alabaster poseur ain't no thing as part-time crook. Mind you, I underestimated the enmity of my fellow rappers who saw no place for me in the fraternity. He's not freestyling, he's styling thieving. Let me introduce you to Noxious Nitro, aka Claudius Creep, featuring Bendy Font and Boy Tone Deaf. We are not your friends. Yeah, that's right. Threaten him. Say something unpleasant to the fool. So he's clutching his rapping trophy there. Who are coming at you like a meerkat? It was supposed to be the most glorious night of my career, and instead I woke up in a dumpster behind the MTV Awards amongst a load of old rubbish and techno dance albums. As a drunk hobo there. The shock of it caused me to develop a stutter. My mojo turned to boohoo, so I remade myself and dedicated my life to becoming the most despicable form of life imaginable in order to have my revenge. The opposite of everything good and decent and brave in this world, I became a music industry lawyer. If there was one thing I learned that prepared me to be a lawyer in a way that no law book or law school could teach me, the enemy of my enemies, enemy is the friend of my enemy, who is also the enemy of my Everybody Hates Music Industry Stooges. I died in a hail of bullets in a drive-by shooting, which was really odd as I was in bed at the time. No one tried too hard to find my killers. When questioned as to the possible identity of my killer, the investigating officer said they were using Google as a source for suspects. Now the unquiet soul of Soul Goulman must wander the earth like a 70s concept album, torturously monotonous and pointlessly, endlessly circling the living. And that's the end of his story. So I'll have control of Soul Goulman. I guess we can open the door then and leave.
80 years? Let's see if we can't expedite the process a little. Expedite? Expedite? Explicate? Man, nobody's going to believe I'm a lawyer. Oh, I can taste that biscuit in Goldman's mouth. Right, how do I get out of here?
There's some interesting looking fellas in the back here. A couple of vampires, I guess. And is that werewolf sitting there and a bull? Let's talk to them.
Hello, officer.
Don't distract me. I'm guarding these air perps.
What were they arrested for?
Crimes unspecified.
Does that mean you don't know exactly what they did?
Perhaps.
So it seems that all of the police officers in this Wailing Heights are bulls?
Goulman! Saul Goulman! I need a man of your particular skills.
What sort of skills would those be then? I play mean blues harmonica.
All valuable in certain situations, but not today. See those three precipitators over there?
You mean perpetrators?
I don't know. You're the silver-tongued lawyer. Anyway, two of them are innocent. The other one is guilty.
Guilty of what?
Security fraud.
What? Selling fake pensions to the dead?
Hence the crime. Anyway, see if you can use your ghostly powers to find out which of those scumbags I should arrest.
Happy to help.
You possess soul, press X to transform into Spectre.
I think I'm invisible. If this day couldn't get any weirder or cooler.
So now we can move around and through the doors and stuff, I guess.
Goulman! Goulman! Saul Goulman!
Oh, right, me.
Yes, you! Get over here! Hey, where'd Saul go?
So I think that the lawyer here is modeled after Better Call Saul, maybe. Let's talk to these guys.
Oh, Danny boy, the pipes are calling. I need to update my blog about this.
I can't wait to clock out so I can get home and start frauding people again. I just arrested these guys to throw the heat off me. Fools. I'm the greatest fraudster of securities that ever walked the afterlife. No one will know my secret that I'm the real criminal masquerading as a cop.
So we solved that, I guess. Pretty simple. I go and talk to this guy and tell him.
I know who did it.
Who?
It was your fellow police officer over there. He did it.
Oh, mine? Really?
I heard him loud and clear.
That sucks. Now I got to call internal affairs.
Can I go now?
Yeah, thanks, Saul. I'll clean up this mess.
Should I sit out the door?
Don't panic. Deep breath. Just breathe. I have no lungs. Guess that's why I'm not hyperventilating right now. Okay.
Step one. Make my way to the town hall library. Easy. Step two, find a book on human rights. Step three, bring it back here and exonerate my body before I end up a permanent resident. How hard can that be?
So let's just look here. It doesn't say library anywhere. Crematory, rough house, saloon, town hall, and we came from the police station. It's a nice looking little fountain there with blood in it. There's some guy standing over here. Let's talk to him.
Hello, citizen.
Zombie. Out for brains. Let's go into the town hall. It's a ghost bureaucrat here. Let's talk to her.
Hey, I was wondering if you could help me.
Make it quick, Saul. I'm busy.
Any idea where I could get myself a book on human rights?
And what would a low-level, second-rate lawman like Saul Gulman need something like that for?
I've been... a client of mine has been wrongfully in prison.
A client? You? What poor sap got stuck with you as a lawyer?
Indeed.
Anyway, your client's out of luck. Human reference section is on the top floor. And as you may recall, top floor is BLTY access only.
BLTY?
Better lawyers than you.
Top floor, you say? Mind if I float on up?
You know you're tethered to the ground floor, Gulman. And I don't see a promotion in your near future.
Is there any way I could nip up to the top floor?
If you could grow wings, you could fly up.
Delivery from the crematory.
About time. Is it still even warm?
Well, it was wriggling when I left the shop. At this point, I'd say semi-coagulated at best.
Well, leave it on the counter and flap off.
Keep the bag, old bag.
I should have said old hag, that would have rhymed.
Transmorphing in public. Kids these days just have no self-respect. Anyway, what was I saying?
Something about sprouting wings.
Ha! Yeah.
Right, let's check the bag. I'll leave.
Hey! Well, the crematory seems to have drawn a bit of a crowd tonight.
Emphasis on the bit.
A little vampire joke there. Alright, let's head over to the crematory. Some music in the distance.
Well, this place looks cozy. The blood and fangs are your idea of cozy. Hey, mate. Excuse me.
Sorry, Spook. Didn't see you there.
Yeah, you're hilarious. How is that hilarious? Didn't see him, like, because he's a ghost. It's a joke.
Hello. Hello!
Oh, hey, Spooky. Couldn't hear you with my phones on.
What are you listening to?
It's this totally wicked new indie track. You probably wouldn't like it. It's like it was written just for me. Wanna hear?
Sure, I like music. Written just for you, huh?
Yeah, cause my name's Lola.
Oh, that's deep.
You wouldn't understand.
So now we can try and control her, but I guess we'd need some more info.
So, Lola, would you say you love tonight's band?
Is it a band tonight? No, I'm just here because I love the Hemolates. They make a cracking AB negative.
Hemolate?
You'll figure it out.
Huh.
Yummers.
May I offer you a nibble of this fine clotted cream?
Ugh! No, you freak! I hate that stuff!
Whoa, chill out, lady.
Hate, hate, hate. I tell you, hate.
Okay, I get it. You hate clotted cream.
Don't say that word!
Eam.
Oh!
A bit overdramatic, don't you think?
Hate!
She does not like clotted cream.
Why are you bringing earphones to a concert?
Excuse me, but my music sensitivities are very,
sensitive?
Extremely. If I listen to anything but exactly what I want right now, I would totally die.
But you're already...
It's called a metaphor.
I like how she has garlic on her pants as a vampire. Alright, I think that's it.
Have a medium day.
Nah.
Just talk to the last guy here.
Excuse me.
Nice suit.
Speak for yourself.
I was.
And the bouncer.
Beat it, speak. Vampires only?
But I'm a huge fan of. Legend. I've got her entire box set. What?
First of all, it's leg end.
Second, leg end is he.
Third, it's his debut album.
And fifth, at the risk of sounding redundant, vampires only?
Hey, that's discrimination, that is.
Get a lawyer.
Hey, wait, I think I am a lawyer.
So you know we have to possess her, but we probably need an item for it. Just one more thing. So let's try and talk to these two vampires that we have not talked to.
The crematory. Bet they do a mean barbecue.
Why are you standing in line if you've already got a coffee?
By the time I get to the front of the queue, this one will be cold.
Didn't you get that one from here?
And your point being?
Is the coffee really that good here?
Mmm, it's absolutely...
What's the matter?
They put AB negative in this. Morons! I said, oh! That's AB negative, right?
Can't tell.
Didn't I freaking say, oh? I totally said, oh. Thank God I'm already back in the queue for another one.
Is there blood in your coffee?
If you can call AB negative proper blood...
Hey, what's your name?
Hear that, guys? The spook is trying it on with me.
No, I wasn't. I swear.
Not a chance in hell, Snowball.
Let's see if you can get that coffee.
Oh, would you like me to throw that in the bin for you?
Fine. But don't expect a tip or anything.
So now maybe we have enough to possess this one over here, Lola.
My place in line.
Oi, Lola, you know the rules.
I know, vampires only. But while all you hipsters are waiting to hate the music inside, why don't you practice hating on this guy?
Did I mention he's a lawyer?
Meh.
That's the spirit. Hipsters unite! Right, now to get that book.
Pay heed to all of Miss Dixoff's instructions until my return, Lola. Safe journey, Papa. In 1728, Papa's getting on a boat and Lola's standing there. Lola bids farewell to her beloved father, who is bound for Mocha to inspect his warehouses. Used to generous freedom, Lola chafes at the new regime, but Papa always allows me to attend the concert in the new spring gardens. Your father entrusted me to keep your reputation intact, Louisa. You may not consort with such low company. It's Lola. You cannot forbid me the theater too. It agitates the mind and excites the senses, which is harmful to a young lady. Why is all that is diverting in life barred to ladies? I guess we're in Victorian England or something like that. We have to mind the virtues. And she sees a wig over here. And she gets an idea. Sleep well, Lola. Greetings, Lawrence. You crave stimulating discourse among the lively masses. To the coffee shop. She puts on the wig. And I guess assume the name of Lawrence. Lawrence fell in love with coffee and became friendly with William Vandenberg, a German composer visiting London. You are a partisan, sir. Bach, while talented, will never match our Henry Purcell for sheer grandeur. My God, Lawrence, you are stubborn and wrong. Time will prove me right. I could argue with you eternally, dear boy, and perhaps I should. You are a woman. You are a vampire. I guess he just bit her in the neck. By the hallowed bean, freedom turns into a bat. Change shape, change identity, live forever. And that's how Lola got started. But now we can head into the crematory.
I love a man whose velour waistcoat matches his flip-flops.
Back of the line, please.
I guess not. So how do we get in there? So maybe we can get to the top of the town hall. Just moonwalking to the town hall. So let's see if we can fly somewhere from here. Ah, looks like we can enter over here. So we made it upstairs.
I don't think anyone's been up here for decades, judging by the dust and corpses. Oof, must be a little rusty. Aha, jackpot! Wailing Heights' civic code for matters involving or related to humans living, the unabridged 26-volume edition. Now, human rights, PQ, volume R. Got what I need. I'm sure the right answer's in here somewhere. Now, to get back down to good old dependable Mr. Ghoulman and blow this pop stand. Well, this was way easier than I thought.
So we could go down here. I wonder what she would say to that. Maybe she'd confiscate the book, but let's just do it.
Can't go that way. That old ghoul will have me done for desecrating the attic.
Ah, okay, so we do fly out.
Wow, this tome weighs a ton.
What? We dropped the tome? So we can't bring it in bat form?
How am I gonna get this down to the police station?
There must be something else here that we can use. So let's try dropping it.
I could drop the book out of the window and get it at the bottom. Genius! Here goes. Ew! That did the job. I can't imagine what might be lingering in the bins of the dead. What was that?
So now it's not here?
Oh, you've got to be kidding me. It was out of my hands for what, 5 seconds? Who would run off with a dusty old... What the? Somebody's coming.
Whew! Did you frighten yourself dropping that stink bomb?
Wasn't me. Trust me, I'll let you know.
Whew!
I'm catching a whiff of it now.
Whew! It's wafting over from the town hall off for Ferrigno's sake. Some bin hooker's been raiding the trash.
Probably some vamp scrounging for second-hand kitty litter that can pass off as shabby chic.
Ah, Ben smells a month-old prawn biryani and year-old egg mayo with just a hint of... Wait for... Yes, Daffo, a light dusting of law library parchment.
Volume R, I believe.
Oh, now you're just showing off.
Wanna chase that scent down? I can practically see the stink trail in the air.
Tempted, but we're already late for Vegan Vendredi and Roughhouse Pack wait for no man nor beast.
Vegan Vendredi, my favourite day of the week.
Stink trail in the air, huh? I can't see anything. But maybe if I were a werewolf, I might.
So we'll have to find the werewolves again and possess one of those.
Whoa! I thought this place looked scary in the dark.
It looks like it's open now, so let's head in.
Hey, hey, you people! Come in! Woo!
Hey, this isn't so bad.
Hey, friend! Friend! Hey! Hey! Hey, friend!
Hey.
Oh, she said hey! She said hey! She said hey!
Oh, you guys are so adorable. You're like puppies. I could just hug all of you. These guys are idiots.
Hey, Arm!
Just take a look at the scenery.
You could help me out? Well, I was just over at the town hall and...
That was you? You're shabby chic?
No. Well, yes. Look, I stashed something in the trash and somebody ran off with it. I need a top-notch nose to help me find it.
Really? Is that it?
Yep. So, can you help me out or not?
Maybe. Let me think about it while I finish this drink.
Wow, this place is really friendly. Sorry?
Great to meet you. I love meeting new people.
Me too.
Made a face, nephew.
Is that customary?
Well, yes. In fact, it's encouraged. Nice. Now I'll never forget you. Don't you guys do this?
No, not vampires generally. We just scoff at each other.
Oh well, that sounds nice too, but nothing like sniffing a butt. Go on, try it.
Yeah, go on.
There you go, we're BFFs now.
You've done that drink yet?
Nope.
So can you...
Maybe.
Are you saving this seat for anyone special?
My best friend should be back any second. Great guy. Total alpha.
Yeah? When's he gonna be along?
Oh, any second now. See, he's a bit slower these days since...
Yes, I do. I love tragic backstories.
Listen up. Back when he was in Vietnam.
Wait, he was in Vietnam?
No. Nambra Farms. Just up the road. Chicken farm. Anyway.
Ooh, here he comes now.
Hey, you pack of hurry huskies! Tail's looking perky tonight, pooches.
Oh, Norm.
Seriously? This song again? And the evening started so well. Now that's a tune you can wag your tail to, rough! Oh, bump in the rough house! Most enchanted to see you, my unhirsute vixen.
Call me
Lola. Can I call you?
Can I call you a cat?
Alright guys, that's the game. Wailing Heights. It's a musical adventure game set in a comic book world. Pick it up if you think it looks interesting. I'll put the link in the description. Thank you for watching and I'll catch you all next time.